everybody. Welcome to the Spotter Stand channel and to the topic of the NASCAR Chicago Street Course. Today was announced a 3-year deal for at least the NASCAR Cup Series to come to Chicago from 2023 to 2025 and run 4th of July weekend in the regular season. NASCAR's really first ever street race. They've had different, the Linden Airport race back in the day. I believe they've had some ARCA races and stuff like that on street courses or courses similar to street courses. And it's a really interesting move. It's a move that does have pros and does have cons. It's a move that has kind of split the fan base. And it's a really big deal for a lot of reasons. So I guess we can start off with the pros. The pros are big markets. And what that means, at least for the first year, at the very least for the first year, it's short-term benefits, but there's some benefits. Some benefits short-term are better than none long-term. So it's likely going to be a pretty sizable crowd, regardless of how many fans there are in the area. With just the surplus of people in the Chicago, Illinois area, it's likely to draw a pretty good crowd. TV ratings are likely going to be really high. In a market like that, it's going to draw interest from a lot of Chicagoans that probably wouldn't turn on NASCAR normally, then obviously the normal fan base, and then fan bases from other large cities, or just fans in general who are intrigued by the prospect of NASCAR doing a street race. Another pro is the next gen races well on road courses. Now this course doesn't look like it has too many passing zones. It's the same course, at least to my knowledge, that they ran in the iRacing Pro Invitational race that they did last year. And that was fairly boring race. I believe the winner was, I think it was a 15. Was it James Davison maybe that won by like 20 seconds or something? So it's definitely, while the next gen has raced really good on road courses, I'm not sure how great the racing product will be. Hopefully it'll be really good. Hopefully these cars can just make the track good. Hopefully we can make this a really good show. Regardless, it's going to be a big event. It's going to be, a big race as you get later into the regular season, but it's going to be a big event as well. It's not just going to be a NASCAR race, it's going to be a NASCAR event. And based on how all in they went today, Chicago and NASCAR did at just the press conference with the cars of Bubba Wallace and Ross Chastain and maybe Joey Logano was the four. Bubba Wallace was there along with NASCAR President Steve Phelps. And there was a lot of hype around the whole announcement. Mayor Lori Lightfoot was there. So it's a big deal. And this is going to get NASCAR a lot of press. Whether that's negative press from racing critics or positive press or non-opinionated press from people in the Chicago area that are like, hey, NASCAR's having a race in our city this week. It's all good in terms of recognition and in terms of getting NASCAR's name out there. For a sport like NASCAR, whose best and most popular days are likely behind them forever, if we're going to return to those or any semblance of those, getting recognition like this is big. And even if this is just a 3 or 4 year deal, which I expect this will be a little more long term, but even if this is a 3 or 4 year deal, getting the good press and getting just eyes on the sport is a big win at this point in the sport. Because it's, it's a sport that, yes, let's be real here, has been trending downwards. And while it's stabilized and even seen an uptick these past couple of years, things definitely aren't as good as they could be. With this next-gen car and how good it's been racing at all but, one or two tracks, if the audience could be there, if the audience gets there, the sport has a chance, I believe, in my opinion, to reach those mid-2000s and late 90s levels of popularity, because the on-track product is the best we've seen in a really long time. There's rivalries, there's intense playoff fights, or intense playoff battles, and let's be real, while the Chase, came in the waning years of that popularity, and actually, the most popular years of that popularity stretch, NASCAR's not going to go back to anything other than the playoff system. That is likely the point system for a really long time. That's just the way sports work nowadays. You have to have playoffs, and NASCAR's not going to wane from that. But with the playoff battles and drama we're seeing, with the rivalries we're seeing, with the great racing we're seeing, with the scale of the crashes that we're seeing, which I know draws in outside viewers, if the sport can get eyes on it like it will with Chicago, the sport has a chance to grow exponentially. And whether it can get back to the levels of its peak or not is a moot point. The point is, this will help the sport at the very least short term. Even if it's a crappy race, this will help the sport in terms of getting eyes on it, getting ears on it, and getting people to read it in the newspaper headlines that, hey, NASCAR had a race, what channel's the next one on? Let's check this out. And then maybe they'll buy a ticket for the next year and spread the word to their friends, and they'll buy tickets. So it's just, you know, at the very least, it's good for getting your name out there as a sport and as a company. And that's a very good. I believe the pros do outweigh the cons. Now, the cons, like I said, the racing product might not be the best. I know it's just iRacing. I know a simulator is obviously much different than the real deal. And I know this is a whole new car. That street race was with the Gen 6 cars, which didn't necessarily struggle in road course racing. We saw some great moments, but the races were tended to be very strung out. And they have been this year, but we've seen more cars around each other. We've seen much better racing. We've seen, even when there are dominant drivers, there are a few drivers that match them on speed, or there are a few drivers that are able to battle them for the end at the win. And road courses are an integral part of this series. Now, one thing that does stink, another con, we're losing Road America, and we're also likely losing a chance to return to Chicagoland in the near future, because NASCAR probably feared that that Chicago, Midwest, Illinois market would be oversaturated with dates. And while, yes, Road America did put on a pretty good show last year, the racing this year was kind of lackluster. The attendance, though, was great, over 100,000 for both races. But TV viewership was down much farther than it should have been on NBC last year. And this year on USA, it garnered less than 2 million on a channel that has been performing very well in the ratings in every other week that we've had. We're not sure about Loudon yet, but... You know, that's been the consensus. Much more viewers for Xfinity and Cup than what happened on FS1. It stinks that we're losing Road America for Cup. However, I love Xfinity stayed with. That's become a good tradition, and it usually puts on a better race. It put on a better race in Cup, in my mind. Kyle Larson, you know, battling Ty Gibbs. Gibbs holding him off this year was great. There's been other several great moments. You know, Kyle Busch holding on to win last year. But, it's unfortunate that that series is leaving the track when fans are clearly so passionate about it, when there's a lot of hype around it. However, if Xfinity goes there, and heck, maybe even Trucks could join them. Maybe Trucks could join in on the 4th of July fun. They haven't had, they don't usually race on 4th of July weekend, I don't believe. It would be fun for them to go there. Maybe have, you know, Xfinity on Sunday and Trucks on Saturday. You know, give it that Saturday-Sunday big event feel still. And maybe, get this, you can move around time. I know that'd be hard with the logistics of the Cup race. Maybe you could do a doubleheader Saturday, or you could start the Xfinity race at noon and the Cup race at 3. Put them both on NBC. And have like a combo, you know, both races on network TV deal. And then maybe Saturday you could put the truck race on Fox, or Sunday put the truck race on Fox at Road America and the Cup race on NBC, switch Xfinity to NBC Saturday. But I think the thing is here that I'm happy about is that this isn't just a one-year deal. Now look, I like Chicagoland more of an option for this area just because it produced great racing before and will probably produce really good racing with the Gen 6 car. And I like Road America as an option because it's a NASCAR staple and the racing's been pretty good. We're not sure. But I do like that this is no one-year deal, and the reason being is the 4th of July weekend. Since 1959, the Firecracker 400 at Daytona was a staple. Until 2019, when the Brickyard 400 became the 4th of July race. It was, again, in 2020. We're like, okay, we might have some stability here. Nope. Now the 4th of July is going to Road America. Okay, 21, 22, okay, now let's move in again. This is a 3 or 4 year deal. And if this catches on event-wise or racing-wise, NASCAR needs stability in 4th of July. It's a huge weekend. And whether the race falls on the 4th or not, obviously more likely to not fall on the 4th. But the weekend itself is a big weekend because, it's a chance for most people if they're working, especially if they need money or if they have to come in on the 4th of July. That's their chance to party and watch sports or do whatever. And it's big that NASCAR has stability in 4th of July, also for at-track crowds. because when you think about it, not much more screams America than fast race cars, beer, and copious amounts of unhealthy food. So it's a chance for NASCAR to kind of spread its wings at 4th of July in a historic city, and we'll just kind of see what happens. You know, whether the racing is good or not, at the very, very least, I think this will be a win for NASCAR in the very short term. Just due to the sport getting notoriety back, due to the sport getting a claim to fame in Chicago, due to the sport getting a lot of eyes and ears and whatever on it, because it's going to be a big deal. If this ceremony and this announcement was pumped up today as much as it was, I'm excited at the very least for what the NASCAR marketing team and what Chicago as a city will do in terms of marketing and advertising this race. As of now, we only think it's a standalone race, but who knows, Xfinity or Trucks or ARCA or whoever could come with it. IMSA is going to be there as well, so that'll kind of be its draw. Maybe some IMSA fans will stick around for NASCAR and vice versa. But it's going to be an exciting weekend next year nonetheless, simply because the element of the unknown. You know, we've seen that a few times. Last year with Road America and Cup, this year with New Atlanta, you know, Nashville last year, Bristol Dirt last year. NASCAR fans are the worst at accepting change, but it seems like when they like a change, they really go all in on it, and that'll be something interesting to watch. So those are just my thoughts. Make sure you like the video and subscribe to the channel, comment, and share, and let me know your thoughts in the comments below. I'll see y'all in the next video. Goodbye.